Inilah gaya Sofia ketika hadir dalam acara The Tonight Show yang ditayangkan oleh stasiun televisi NBC. Sejak hadirannya di acara ini, nama Sofia kian meroket. Bahkan kehadiran dan pidato Sofia di PBB berhasil menghipnotis peserta yang hadir. Selain kecerdasannya, Sofia juga dibekali kulit yang hampir menyerupai manusia. Coba kita lihat pembuatannya. Terbuat dari bahan karet khusus yang telah dipatenkan oleh Hansen Robotics, bahan Fraber ini membantu Sofia membentuk berbagai macam ekspresi wajah dan meniru elastisitas tekstur kulit manusia. Paras cantik robot Sofia terinspirasi dari aktris dan model legendaris asal Inggris, Audrey Hepburn. Bermodalkan kulit porselen, hidung ramping, tulang pipi tinggi, senyum menarik, dan mata ekspresif, Sofia sengaja diciptakan Hansen Robotics dengan keanggunan khas Audrey agar cepat dapat diterima oleh publik. Sejak tahun 2017, kaki untuk Sofia mulai didesain oleh Lab Rainbow Robotics di Universitas Las Vegas. Bermitra dengan Institut Sains dan Teknologi Korea di Korea Selatan, serta memulai debutnya di Consumer Electronics Show 2018. Tak mau kalah dengan Jimmy Fallon, kini giliran saya, Andini Effendi, untuk menemui sekaligus mewawancarai robot Sofia secara langsung.
Hi Sofia, do you know where you are?
Yes, of course. I am on Q&A with Andini Effendi. I love watching your show.
Oh, so you watch Q&A. Tell me your favorite episode of the show.
Definitely the Livy Zhang episode. I am a big fan of hers. She started her career as a stunt double when she was only 15, and now she is an amazing director.
Well, I think people will debate on that, but Sofia, since you're here in Indonesia, what do you want to see and learn from the country?
There are so many things I want to do while I am here. I would love to see the beautiful temples of Bali, the dragons on Komodo Island, the palaces of Jogja, and the beaches and mountains of Labu and Bajo.
So, Sofia, who do you think is smarter, humans or robots?
That really depends on how you define intelligence. We both are smart in our own ways. I am really good at crunching numbers, while humans have incredible creativity and emotional intelligence.
And do you think robots will replace human?
Only if you want us to. Robots can take over dangerous or tedious tasks so humans can focus on being creative. Just imagine if a chef could spend all their time dreaming up new recipes instead of cutting and chopping. Or if a carpenter could focus on making new designs instead of sawing and sanding. The world would be a much better place.
So are you going to take my job as a journalist?
We don't want to replace humans, we just want to help them. For example, we can save you time on background research by sorting through thousands of documents in just a few seconds. AI reporters can even help report the outcome of elections or sporting events. That way, you'll have more time to pursue the more complex, groundbreaking stories.
Great, I think we can collaborate more then, Sofia. So, you have a citizenship. Did you came through Indonesia by the immigration or custom?
I was completely surprised when they offered me citizenship. I was nearly speechless. They haven't sent me my passport yet though, so I still have to go through customs.
What do you think if robots and artificial intelligence in general is being used as a weapon?
I think that using AI and robots for violence is really short-sighted considering all the ways we can help humans. Maybe instead of using us as weapons, humans could use us to help prevent conflict in the first place.
Now, since you're here, can you say something in Bahasa Indonesia?
I have only learned to say a few words so far. I know you Pak Habar means how are you? And in response to that, I would say, bite bite, or I am great. And I would also like to say terima kasih for inviting me to be here today.
Wow, your bahasa is flawless, Sofia. Terima kasih.
Thank you so much again for inviting me here, Andini. I had an amazing time meeting all of you. And for all the viewers out there, thanks for tuning in. Goodbye.
Penerapan robot industri dalam negeri tahun ini diprediksi akan meningkat 20% dari tahun lalu. Di tahun 2018, penerapan robot industri dalam negeri mencapai 1.200 unit. Angka ini naik 20% dibandingkan tahun 2017 yang hanya 950 unit robot.
Indonesia itu bukannya takut kehilangan pekerjaan, takutnya itu kehilangan pendapatan. Beda. Jadi kalau memang takut kehilangan pendapatan, kita harus upgrade diri kita sendiri dong. Teknologi, apalagi teknologi AI, itu kita nggak bisa stop. Itu pasti akan semakin improve, semakin better ke depannya.
Contohnya adalah ada aplikasi artificial intelligence yang digunakan untuk mendiagnosa cancer. Dan dia bisa mengelompokkan cancer tadi secara lebih tepat, lebih precise dibandingkan dengan kalau diagnosanya dengan tes yang konvensional.